Hello, and today I'm going to play Elite SuperBlitz Arena on the chess. Let's have fun, and let's go! Okay. Let's join. Alright. So it seems like Abdusatorov is maybe going to win the title still. Because, I mean, he drew. Magnus is looking like a draw position against Prague. So far, looks like a draw. Well, not draw. Yeah, I mean, position is drawn. So Giri is losing to... No, it was lost, but now it's drawn. Playing Alexander 2006. Oh, Chip and Enko. Only I'm playing against it now. Cool. I'm not sure about that. Okay, doesn't. Yeah, so Giri was like lost. And it was drawn, then he was. He blundered. It was minus 3, but Jordan didn't find rook c1 there. Then it was drawn. Magnus against Prague, just like some perpetual summer, I guess. How am I going to win this? Let's try like that. Okay. I mean, yes, take. Oh no, wait. Yeah, I mean, now c6. So, queen b6 is this. Yeah, I take. This. This. Queen here, this. I mean, g5 is possible as well. Yeah, I think g5 and getting his bishop, so this is a weakness, and b5 is a weakness as well. Yeah, I mean, Prague should have like perpetual, I guess. Magnus, oops, play. Okay. Yeah, I take. I mean, Queen e4 is crazy, so he won't do it, I hope. I mean, well, I actually hope he will, because then I'll win a queen. Okay. F7 hangs. Yeah, g6, I was thinking of just going back. b5. Targeting b5. Okay. Now I just need to find a plan how to win. This. I was thinking about that and this. Yeah, probably transmission broke or something, so Fabio against Skymar. Okay. Rook c5 works, doesn't it? Yeah, and then b5 hangs. And if he takes c5, then I have d takes c, winning his queen, so it's good. Then this here. Let's play bishop e1. And Gukesh is drawn against Aronian. Rapport is against Dinigan, and Parham is swinging against Arjun. This queen 6 takes. I mean, I'll never lose this pawn. I just put bishop here, but I don't know how to advance it also. Looks good. Yeah, I got another pawn. Oh, I can just do this. Gotta be careful. Quadruple connected passers, and I wonder if Alexander 2006. Okay, that was pretty good, I think. Maybe I didn't play perfectly, but okay. Archon had to go queen e1. Yeah, then that would be draw, but he played bishop e8. After queen e4, he was lost. Okay. So it's just one forest. Prague. Yeah, Prague found move and play against Ashkan 2022. I think it was pretty alright. If knight b5, I had bishop f7 or what? Or e5, yeah, seems like that. Oh, b3 is the move I play, but okay, whatever. We could have got the same position from French, to be fair. e4, e6, knight f3, c5. Yeah. e4, e6, we need to c5, there you go. And my idea is just like long side castle and play d4. What about that? His queen and his knight hangs, and if queen f5, I have queen b5. And then if he takes. Okay, yeah, he just gets knight. Nice. And now knight e5, and I like one. So some sort of miniature. Well, it's just better to 7, I guess. Cool. Well, that was pretty nice. It's like actually really good. And the Ashkan 2022. That was insane. I mean, maybe it wasn't great, but yeah, now I'm just winning. Yeah, it's impossible. I mean, first of all, this wasn't great, and then that was just total blunder. Cool. Played here. Yeah, basically this and queen a5 has this queen trade. Queen a5, queen b5, take here, and this I'm winning. GG! Plains Heimars m142. Okay, let's go e5. Okay, d5? E5? How do I play the Albin Contra Gambit? I have no idea. Somehow, like you play normal chess, I guess. I just didn't play. And Kinsindian is such a rare opener, to be fair. Kinsindian, Kins Gambit. Oopsie. Yeah, it looks like I drew Prague. I mean, it's move 40 already. Wait. Huh? Takes. Of course, takes here. I was thinking about this. And I cannot short tight castle. Probably I'm going like by his prep or something. Slick doesn't think at all. This. Not too sure about bishop b5 though. I think unless I'm blundering something, I mean the worst is I'll be a pawn down, but I'll castle. That's actually pretty good for me, I think. I'm not sure if I should go. If I should go knight g2 though, or no. And I mean knight g2, it's like rook g1, bishop h3, but then he has knight g5 and that doesn't look good. So, okay, I gotta like hurry up. Is this knight e7, knight g6, I take, so he probably goes there, then I play bishop f5, and rook here, I take his rook and bishop g6. That looks like equalized. Not a long time, but okay. I perfectly predicted the game. And he takes on e3. I take that as a draw. I'm low on, I mean, knight g7, I just take. Probably going to be a little bit less pleasant, but I have rook d7, rook d8 anyways. Yeah, he does that, this. Yes, it's strong. Mm-hmm. I'll try to get him, to be fair. To be honest, I'll try to break through. It's funny, but okay, I'll try. Yeah, I mean, that's a draw, of course. Well, my throat to make. This. I mean, I won't lose, I can just put bishop here. It's fine. This. And my idea, like, king b5 and try to overgrind this. Oh, let's put bishop here. I think I can play, like, h5 just to fix pawn structure there. And now just, like, cool. I mean, that's true. Yeah. Let's play. It's like total draw, like the most drawn position the chess could ever see. But I'm trying to win this. Just funny. Draw and draw the game. Heimer 7-1-4-2. Yeah, that was like equal all the game. So queen e5 check from Magnus. Yeah, king g8, and it's probably going to be a drawn play. And it's boring openings only. Let's. Oh no, that's really boring. He was right. Ha. H play h3. And then g4. Okay, but he didn't play it. Ha. Yeah, bishop b6, nice move. That was lost. Yeah, but then he let me escape. Yeah, probably Magnus is going to force a draw. It's like insanely hard to play and win there. So yeah. probably. Or is Magnus going to play Queen G3? But wait, Queen G3, there is this and then there is that, right? And yeah, I mean, you can just take. Alone. Doesn't that just lose a... Yeah, that does, doesn't it? That loses two pawns. Maybe not two, but one. Is there some, like, knight h3 sacks? Well, I mean, if d takes e, I'm going to go queen d8, rook d8. Bishop f7, king f7, knight e5, king e6, bishop f4, I think doesn't work because of g5. Yeah. But I can just play knight e5 and be a comfy, healthy, just whole pawn up, I guess. Oh, yeah. And he has to play like 96. Awful. Haha, that's interesting. I mean, I'll take. Okay, the game was king g8. And then queen b8, I mean, king g7. Now the question is Magnus going to force a draw? Or is Magnus going to try to win it somehow? Interesting question. But if Magnus doesn't win this game, then he probably can say bye to the title of the winner of this tournament. Oh, let's just play a4, a5 idea. He blocks it. Knight g5 looks nasty. Well, let's go for it. I mean, this my throat. It's nickname says it's just boring opening something, but I'm going to trying to fire things up, you know, so it will be some fireworks in his opening. So he then will change his nickname to really like aggressive opening, so just like this. Yeah, this I take, and queen f6, I play bishop g5. Here king h1 and queen f2, king h1 as well. Yeah, let's see. So Rapport won against, yeah, Din has not the best. There was Berlin? No, it wasn't Berlin. It's interesting. And then Ding suddenly... Oh, Ding just miscalculated. Or blundered. I mean, he took a pawn, but then this and a Rapport just won an exchange. Aye, aye, aye. Ooh, that's bad. That's the nicest feeling, yeah. So... I mean, he'll probably take f takes e. Again, that's forced mate, isn't it? I mean, if he goes king h7, he sees after bishop f6, rook g8 here, so he has to go here, then I can sack my rook. Be nasty. Okay. No, second rook it doesn't work, it's just like when you're on bishop f6 it does. And I mean rook g8, queen g5 mate. Nice. Okay, Magnus plays queen g3. So he doesn't want that draw. Okay, my opponent is dynamo 3 and boring opens only. Yeah, it was interesting game. Maybe I didn't play it perfectly, but I played it quite well, I think. Blin's new way 23. Ooh, okay. I mean, Prague can just create for your computer, actually. Just like stand and say, you have nothing! You cannot break through! Yeah, okay, let's play d5. Oh no, it's Catalan, but thank you that you didn't go for Catalan. Yeah, queen trade, that's actually playing like my previous opening, boring openings only. Yeah, I don't know. But I'll try to add something interesting in the end game, so my nickname will be interesting end games only. Bishop h3. Wait, does it work or doesn't? I mean, take rook h3. And all content, all the way. This battle just doesn't want to close, help me. Ah, finally. I lost to this guy in Blitz, right? It was like 2 weeks ago. There was a good game against Born Open, so... Oh, no, did my intern crash out? Yeah, I played 1 week ago, SuperBlitz, but it was 2 weeks, I just wanted to change that. Okay, rook h3. I mean, I can take that as well. Oh, dog of gf, because I mean, if rook c3, he can take bishop d8, bishop b6, and it will be opposite color bishops. But that, then I go here, knight g7, king g7, I'm good. And if knight f6, I go king, f8, rook c1, rook d3, and g4 hang, then that looks good. Oh, that's right. And yeah, rook c3 was fine, but then bishop d8, it's opposite color bishop, it will be like very boring. Okay, Prague actually went queen d1, this table basis doesn't work right, nope. Wait, am I blundering thumbs in? I don't think so. Well, I did. No, wait, I did. What? He had rook e3. Rook e3 would not be nice. And take, he has bishop e7. But here we can just take. Can't I? I think I can. I mean, if things knight f4, I have rook c3 first, but then knight d5 plus, but I have rook d4 as well. So I think, yeah, he miscalculated somewhere. Well, let's just play bishop d7, I guess. So 2 pawns up. That's nice. Maybe bishop b7 isn't the best move. Okay. It's definitely fine. And just bishop c6, block this file off. Yeah, I can see c5 is interesting, like... Magnus wants to win, and Prague, I think, is fine with the draw. It was, like, interesting game. But it was more or less equal so far. Bishop b5, nasty end, doesn't it? Isn't it? And rook b5, rook d1. Bam! Nice, I don't want to dream. Well, not yet, but soon. Wait, this. I can play f5, f4. You cannot take, you can move his rook, you can just move his king to f1 and play pawn moves. But if pawn move, then I take, I've gen, and I'm. Cool. I mean, whatever. Let's just do this. Then pawn goes. I mean, he has to stop one of these pawns, and he cannot even make any pre-move traps. And I want him UA23. It was a good game, wasn't it? It was pretty good, I think. Playing Semenichev, Alexander. Ah, why didn't he go e4? That's such a shame. Karokhan. Yes. Let's go. Karofan. Something interesting, like, definitely not mainline or anything. Can I? I'm not sure about knight d5. Yeah, I'm not sure about bishop d5 as well. Let's play rook e1, like queen c1. Just need to be careful with mate for pawn. Hey, rook c3, I would be losing. I miscalculated that. Yeah, rook c1 one move before. But then I was winning in my battle again. Doesn't want to close. Well, I can play this or this. I think I'm gonna go queen b3. Yeah, queen bishop b3. This. Rook e4. Sure. And knight g5 is a threat. I mean, I can be like nasty and play c4 c5. Ah, you know what? Let's go. Just dominating position. Rook f7? Question mark. Now, if he goes knight eg6, nope. Probably play. What is this? Ooh, no, wait, don't I don't. No, content! Ooh, ooh. No, wait, I'm not sure it's. Okay, content all the way, come on. Content. I mean, knight f7 worked as well. Like, knight f7 probably was easier, knight f1, knight d8, queen f4. But this, we should be 6. And then, like, knight g, knight. Yeah, well, that I'm happy to get my exchange back. The thing I'm not so happy that he gained some activity. If I play like queen g5, it should be alright. Yeah. Okay, so, I mean, queen e5 computer is just not happy. And it will be, oh, it's a draw. Of course, I can read computer mind. Yeah, okay. Ah, my knight is somewhat weak now there. Wait, I'm not so sure about this. Maybe it's just alright. Split like rook c1 with idea of bishop g5. Yeah, let's be careful with this. Knight f7, I should have stuck with knight f7. Okay, let's play faster. Oh dear, now he has queen d4. Oof, that's unpleasant. No. Oh dear, that's getting interesting. I have like no time, but okay. Yes, really weak king position. Oh, I just hung my queen. No, didn't mean to do it. James Stonish falls under. Yeah, just on my queen. Okay, yeah, that was a good game, but the end didn't. Just gave him way too much compensation. Yeah, okay, just 98 would have been the end of the game. Yeah, then I was winning, just hanging queen. Vince Radio Varasavia. Good luck. Yeah, let's see. I mean, yeah, queen e5, I had f1, I would be. Yeah, I just blundered queen. I thought he would take queen c2, but Okay, whatever. Let's forget this game and let's play other games better than I did the last game. Okay. For some similar like 2 games ago. L6, so win in there. And through then plus 4, plus 3, yeah. That's a beautiful position. And a really well played game until time travel. To be fair, yeah, I mean, I just got better from the open knight e8, which just end the game on the spot basically almost. Okay, 6. Okay, so King G8, I mean, it looks like Magnus almost like has to force the draw. And otherwise he'll be a pawn down and Prague will be the one who'll probably put some pressure. Okay. This. Okay. I think I'm in 97 looks all right. Bishop d7, bishop d8, knight c5. So it's like this. If rook d5, I take, and bishop f3, and take with the rook. If he moves through, then I guess I'll just play this. Yeah, I had this calculated. No, wait. Maybe this is that. So bishop f3, that's the only moves I think why he's holding. Because I mean if this I have queen e4. So yes, you go bishop b3 or bishop f3. Wait, that? Oh, that's another move why he's holding. Well, maybe he isn't holding actually. Oh, well, this. That's actually nice. So I'm still keeping pressure on the bishop and bishop f3 rook d1. Yeah, I mean, he had to go bishop f3 or bishop b5. I didn't bishop f3 or bishop b3. I didn't see f4, but luckily for me, I was winning there anyways. Cool. Yeah, that looks winning. I think I'll be at least a piece up. Okay. Yeah, and I'm like really good on time. This I'll take and I'll take with the queen. Because if you take with the bishop, he has e4, but then if queen d1, I'm still winning. But let's make it safe. And I'm ready for Varsavia. GG's. So yeah, I need to get on fire. That would be nice. Let's see what games are left. So, Jordan, yeah, it's a draw against Sanish. Playing other chest. Well, good luck, good luck. He plays Caro Khan. Okay, let's go for French. Many people like actually get like stuck and they play online, they allow e5 and she's there, knight is there and you have this attack for the king, so it's actually cool to play knight f3, d3 stuff. Okay, g3. Yeah, I mean of course it's just sidelines, so that's unpleasant, you have to be careful. Probably don't choose this stuff for your like main repertoire, just playing this for fun, so you better choose. Yeah, okay, I think when he left me castle I should be like all right-ish. Let's play h3, prevent an g4. Oh, I blundered a pawn. Oops. Well, I play queen e2. Well, he didn't take it. I'll play rook e1, knight e3, knight d5, something like this, and queen c2, knight e3 as well. Yeah, this queen c2, knight e3. Yeah, and Gukesh is equal against the Levon. Bishop e3 and bishop d3, queen e4. And he has b5. Oh dear. Oh dear, I didn't see b5. Yeah, this here. B5, I'll have to go back all the way to d1. Play a pawn down position, I guess. I mean, I'm just. Yeah, okay. He found b5, congrats. It offers a draw. Well, thank you for the draw offer, but let's play. Yep, let's. Yeah, because I mean, we are here not for result, we are here for fun, so let's have fun. And with this quick draw, you won't get much fun, to be fair. So let's play! Even if I lose, let's get some fun. I mean, queen d7, I'm like totally lost here, but okay. Okay, then I'll play queen c1. I got a mobile. Yeah. Oh, that was his draw in the tournament. Yeah, seven followers right now. I was like totally lost. And before I just hung, and then there it was a repetition. I tried to flag him, but it wasn't successful. We would be like perfect if I would thack and then like play knight f5. I just want to second exchange for the play. Let's play knight g4, this idea of knight f6, of course. And if he takes knight g4, I play h6g. Okay, a4, Bragg has to be like careful. Queen d1 takes queen g1, but Magnus is like not risking at all. Yeah, h6g, of course. Knight g5. Oh wait, bishop h6. Okay, I gotta play faster. I'm worse on position, let's not be worse on time as well. Yeah, like the good thing when you are worse, you just need to blitz out the moves. And then your opponent has to think, and when your opponent thinks you have more time, and then when you have more time you can flag him, and then when you flag him you win. Even position doesn't matter. Knight h4, for sure. Yeah, probably knight f5 now. Ooh, that's looking interesting. You know what, I'll take, let's go, content! Content. I mean, I'm pawn down. If I don't do anything, it'll probably be worse anyways. Let's sack for content so you can enjoy it. At least. And maybe I'll win. Okay, Prague found queen g1. He'll probably be okay. But everything can happen in chess. Oh no, this. Wait, but this is queen strat. Oh no, it isn't. Oh. Okay, like I'm trying to not let him play bishop h5. In a way, d3. Mm. Still has 2 seconds left. There's still so much time left. But I won. 3-12. I cannot say that was like the clearest game ever. But near for the draw was like -5. -3. Well, so it was pretty bad, but okay. Yeah, time. Oh gosh. Like, I don't know how you had so much time left. You had like 4 seconds and you played like instantly. And then, yeah, I somehow won. GG. And playing Durenmat 2. Good luck. Oh no, Catalan. No! It's Catalan. Okay, at least he goes with his lines. Listen, sequel. Oh wait, you play bishop c6, you don't play b5. Messed up 2 lines. Combine them. Oh well, so we don't have 1 pair of rooks already. It's somewhat good, I guess, because I'm playing these like pieces. I mean, if I play c5, get this pawn to the board, will be like absolutely perfect. Then let's play bishop before we c5 idea. Queen e8 c5. Though now he has knight c3. Let's see. Up. I just gave away my pawn. This is a terrible game against Alicious. Like, legit terrible. Yeah. Okay, so I have compensation for this pawn. Oh, my knight hangs. My composition isn't great, but I have it. At least, maybe. Let's play knight b3 and bishop d5. And e4. I guess I should take and then like queen a4 or queen b8, queen a2. I don't know. Definitely should make a queen move. I think let's go to a2. Is the Ragnos is thinking? But probably, I mean, if it is a draw and then one forest draws, then. No, wait. If, yeah, one forest was winning, but now it's draw, so yeah, if Abdustorp draws, then he'll be onto the tie breaks for sure, and he's playing against one forest tomorrow with white, so draw should be somewhat easy. But if he wants to make absolutely sure, even if Geary wins, it'll be forced he has to win. Win will be harder, but still he's playing with white pieces, so it shouldn't be super hard. I mean, it'll be hard because he's like against really strong players, but yeah, draw should secure him at least tiebreakers. Oh, my position is so passive. I can't even play rook b8 because of like queen c7 stuff. Help me, help. I don't have move, I mean, well, let's play rook d8, so queen c7, at least if like rook g7, I mean, yeah, I'll still have to escape. Okay, let's play. Well, technically it doesn't threaten taking. Don't know. Gosh, I don't want time. Oh, I don't see a move. Like at all. Like, absolutely at all, I didn't see a move. And I mean, see, like, a terrible move. And lost. Like, really lost here. Well, try. And I'm, like, bad on time as well. Yeah, that was a nice... I mean, it was a nice game from opening, but then it just went this pawn. It wasn't so nice. I had to play, like, Queen e8 and then c5. Don't play, didn't have to play this bishop b4 move. Just Queen e8 immediately and then c5. Uh-oh. That's a nice move. Oh, my knight hangs, but it doesn't really hang. No. Yes. Ooh, another endure match too. Wow. Well, that was a little way too close. Yeah, well, I just could have played and beat. Yeah, it would be lost, but still, but yeah, good for me that I didn't, because I got this passer and I won. Yeah, Magnus played f5, Prague has to find Queen g1, Queen g2, then it will be a draw there. It's scary, but it's a draw. Yeah, it was like perfect position until, yeah, I didn't play bishop 6, nobody knows. Yeah. Go for 15 seconds, I didn't play bishop 6. Okay, then it's Daniel Latipov, 2008. Okay. Here. A6. Wait, this is a free, right? It's a freebie. I'll play knight d5. I mean, it's a freebie, but then yes, like bishop b5, and then I'll maybe probably won't even finish developing. So let's not get that freebie, but let's be better. Oh well, not better, but let's not be worse. Okay, knight c3, b5, and bishop b7. Yeah, I don't know why I didn't play bishop g3 immediately. Ah, that's why, probably. Queen c8, and knight d7 is a nice idea. Well, now we'll go back, and then if he goes 95, we'll play 97. Now let's play rook c8 now. Sure, what's the point of h3 to be fair? That I can attack his knight or anything? I could attack his knight. Okay, b4 for sure, with knight d4 idea. Or bc knight d4. Takes. This. Knight d4. Prague is thinking and is getting somewhat low on time. Not like in bullet, but for classical, he's much lower on time than Magnus, for example. Wait, that's a free queen. Yeah. And then the king of one knight g3 check as well. Checks rock. Checks rock. Okay, that was the most sleep. Another name, Daniel Latip of 2008. Nice! Yeah, I actually didn't see myself also that I have this 92 as a threat. Oh, I play as the Grandmaster DJ Howby. Like, let's play g6. He's like okay. So it's some sort of like Sicilian-ish. Definitely different move order, but Sicilian-ish position. B5? No, knight d7 though, it's interesting. Yeah, it was worse actually, okay. Before c blunder, just when c would be a pawn up. Okay. Eliminate take. Rook d8. Yeah, I mean, okay, this is maybe going to be a little unpleasant, or maybe not a little, I'm not sure. Yeah, that's like super unpleasant right now. Play rook 7? Don't know. Like, no, let's play e6 and bishop c4, knight e5 or something like that. Or knight e5 is our bishop c4 now. I'm not sure about e6 though, I mean, my duck's squares can be like real weak. Knight e5, this. Oof, I'm not sure about knight e5. Looks okay. Can take with the bishop now? Sure can. Let's go for it. And if 95, yeah. And now I'll take here. So I'll have one knight left. At least something. Okay. Play queen 7. Is this gonna take? Oh no. Look like h6 for now. Takes. Then here I go, 95. Yeah, 4. Of course, but then this bishop b7, that looks okay. I mean, I have mostly dark square pawns. The light square pawns my king will protect, and dark square pawns my bishop will protect. It's increased relative ease. Let's play h5. Maybe queen trade will happen. Nope. Not yet. He just wants to trade queens, and then he doesn't want to. Or maybe he will. Yeah, okay, he will offer. F3. Is a 5, but okay, didn't go for it. He doesn't want to break through. It's a pity. Play f5. Come on! Play f5. Dream DJ Hobby, yeah, okay, I would have felt bad if I would like him. Yeah, Sony would have been a 50 move rule actually. So 38 and 81, yeah, just 7 moves, yeah. I didn't want to flag him. I could probably play like, put my bishop to d8, play b5, but it wasn't needed. I'm playing Skorak and Mitri, yeah. So 1-2, yeah, that was a good game. Okay, knight f3, and then b3! Let's go! Do. Play e6, come on, don't play d6. Thank you. Yeah. I mean, I know it's chess, but. Yeah, I mean, I could have played b5, put my bishop on b6, make like 50 million moves, play a4, and it's still a draw there. But okay, like, come on. Let's also be human and not just playing for results. I'm not sure about knight 3 because of bishop b4. But it looks okay. This. Yeah, I have to be careful exactly. I think I'll do this and bishop d3. I think I should be alright. I'll be a pawn down. I'm not sure if you'll see it though. Queen c6, bishop b3. Yeah, and yes, knight e4 and pawn down. But then, yeah, I don't know, let's go for it. Okay, didn't go for it, told you. Because you had to go knight e4, then bishop c3, and then queen e4, and then I would have something, but then he would be a pawn up. But okay, let's see what's up here. I think I'll play a3. Probably d takes c because if knight e4 take, or he just castles, but then e5, I think d takes c is his move. Okay, Prime found queen g1, then he has to play queen g2. Okay, he took with the knight? Well, I'm not complaining, but okay, I think I'm just like maybe better. And if e3, bishop, I take and bishop f6, anyways. You should g8 this? Yes, nothing. Wait, maybe it's just bishop g7? I don't know. Why didn't you just take d takes e? And I mean, bishop f6, then g takes f, you're better. But okay, now I think I'm like almost winning. Well, that's pretty good. Okay, e3? Huh? Maybe bishop f6? No, probably just castle. I mean, yeah, he cannot castle because then if rooks, yeah, I'd like much better. Just have to now blunder mate on g2. Should be good to do. Yeah, let's probably play rook f2, so my move. My queen is free to make some moves, and now, I mean, I think up to queen before it's just like GG, but maybe I'll play rook d1 first. Yeah, I think it doesn't hurt. Or queen a5. No, let's play queen b4. Takes, and then like queen d4, I don't know. Yeah, this. Queen c2. Queen d4, rook h6 or something. Maybe even rook e6 works. I don't know. Oh, probably not. No, not now for sure. But now I have rook here and then rook there. And I'm totally winning. Queen h8, rook f7, queen h7, queen e7. That is great! Nice. Yeah, Prague took. Now he has to take on Queen a with g4, g3. So it will be a draw? It should be a draw at least. Will he find it? Yeah, and that's win. King e7, I just played rook f7, queen h7, and queen a7. Nice! That was a decent game, wasn't it? And yeah, it was worse. I know I took knight e4, but then it was a really good realization part, I think. Okay, yeah, probably like g4, g3 will be actually easy for Prague to play from practical point of view. And all the name Koryak and Dmitry. What did I do to myself? Well, now I won. Yeah. I somewhat overcommitted to get this and that, and I won. Nice! Good game. That was pretty good. Cool! That was like a really nice game. Except the opening. Here I was worse. I mean, probably ED or this, and if D. You had to go for this. That, and that probably would be like a draw. Yeah, I have to force it. Yeah, but okay, after what he did in the game, it's like totally winning. Yeah, we don't talk about that. It somewhat threw the advantage away, but he played win straight and I was winning. Yeah, I just like didn't pay much attention to his idea. Oh, well, the chess fell again. Good luck. Oh no, Trapovsky. Oh, I had to play d6, what am I doing now? He has d6 on his own, but okay, doesn't do it. e5 would have been, like, good, I think, maybe? Playing this against Andre. I played this, and I still sometimes play against him. I mean, okay, I don't mind if he doesn't want to castle. I'm fine with him being castle-less. Well, now maybe I can move my knight. I don't know. Let's try it, I guess. Okay, g3. I thought you'd play knight g3. Huh, okay. Yeah, Prague played g4. Looks like a draw will soon be agreed. Or maybe not, I don't know. Yeah, let's trade the rooks. I don't know, to be... It's not nice, it's g5. I'm actually thinking about psyching and playing knight d5 just so he won't have g5. Yeah, that's like real passive position. I mean, I guess my hope to bring my knight into play something like this and an knight d4, then it will be beautiful. But to do that, I need to get like lucky so he won't. Okay, I think g6. And then he left knight d4. Maybe that was actually his idea to provoke me. Play g6 or knight d4, knight f6 then. Don't know. Well, I'm not sure about that because now there's. And yes, knight e4. Oh, I thought you blooded a queen. I was like, for a brief second, I was like, oh, he blooded a queen, nice. But he has bishop, and then I saw he has bishop f5. I was like, no! Maybe actually it was smart to play knight f5 and then bishop f5 and knight c2 and knight d4. Well, I don't know. To attack this pawn. But okay, yeah, he goes bishop e4 now by himself. Maybe I can play like queen e7, queen. Ooh, that looks interesting with queen e5 idea. King f8 and bishop f5, I take, knight h4, knight f5, knight d4, and that looks good. Instead of this. And if bishop f5, I take, and then take. And then king e7, yeah, this king e7. And like knight d4 stuff. Okay, my knight's somewhat stuck here. It's a little problem. I'll play like knight h4, knight c2, and then knight back to f5. And if king d3, I have this, so yes, I go king d2, and if this, I go that, and then my knight is back into play, and I'm not sure if that was good for me. That was a mistake. I'd go f6 immediately because now he has f4 by himself. Okay, it doesn't play though. Let's play b. Ah, now I do. Ah! What am I doing? What is he doing? Wasn't the greatest ending, I think. No. Let's get Mal chess 12. No! I was lost then. Then Salix Sewer. Okay, good luck. Yeah, I just couldn't stop. I just went too far. I had to play King G5. Okay, let's go. Knight here. I need to win, because so far I'm not doing so great. I don't have fire or anything. Okay, here. Oh, I'm not sure. I'm getting into some sharp Sicilian lines, which I have no idea how to play. I'm not sure, probably that's a mistake because you have knight h5. Yeah, I don't know. Well, g6? Wow, that's some sharp Sicilian lines. I'm like first time playing this Knight of Sicilian stuff, and I already got like one of the sharp, well, not one of the sharpest, but like super sharp position. It's actually so funny. Short side castle, or he won't castle now yet. I don't know. I will long side castle. Ooh. Ooh. Rook hf1. Oh, that's getting interesting, you know, like really interesting. Okay. Well, I don't want this knight on f4. Let's get rid of it. Okay, takes. Finally. It was putting some annoying pressure. Probably it wasn't like too bad, but it was somewhat annoying. Wait, what about this? So far I'm a pawn up, but let's not take it easy because I'm playing as GM, so better be careful until the very last move of the game. I'm not sure, I was thinking like bishop b6, knight b6, and queen h6, bishop b4, knight h3, something like this. Probably would have been like nice, but no. I want to like keep pressure on the. Maybe I need to play rook f8 though, I'm not sure. Okay, takes. Over. Yeah, knight c5 probably. I'll maybe take and queen h7. Okay. Getting interesting. B6 is a weakness. Takes. B6 is even a bigger weakness now. And I can just take knight b6, is my idea. Yes, another dream rush, elixir h1. Let's go. Yeah, I mean, against Alucinazo, was a draw. I went just a bit too much. No, it was a long time, so I didn't really have time to calculate. Oh, well, that was a nice game. Yeah. Oh, he had knight g4. Well, okay, and then this. Okay. I played against Meisler Boris, but after that, there was like, except from that, that was like a pretty good game. And there was another mistake in the opening here. He had knight 6, so I'd go for knight c3. Okay. Okay, g4 Magnus is thinking. Yeah, wow. What is this? I'm going to sack a pawn just for. Just. Well, he doesn't want to take my pawn. Now, please. But now. No, he doesn't want to take my pawn at all. Well, okay. b5, d5, e4. Bishop b7. Sounds good. Okay. Okay, I'm not sure about this. Looks a little goofy to me here. Oh, my knight. My knight. That was goofy. It's like really goofy. Well, comeback time. Hopefully. If I won't blunder more knights. Hanging knights in one move like I did. Yeah, exactly. Feels like this. No. That is looking not so good, to be fair with you. Okay, I'll play f5. It's so fun playing a knight down.
I'm playing a knight down. My goal is to get my knight back, but he doesn't give it to me.
I don't know. Seems like this. Galaxy sort of looks likely to win the tournament. Yes, wait a big lead. Is for me to catch so far, but maybe somebody else can catch him. Though I'm working on catching him, at least stopped his fire. Well, yeah, my DS can h8. I mean, I'm like totally lost, he just has everything. Everything wins, but I'm trying, you know, never give up. Just gotta play fast. Okay, putting pressure on e5 pawn. I mean, it's not a pressure at all. Some it is, I guess. Yeah, that's unpleasant. He just wants to trade everything. And I don't want to trade. And it's like forcing me to trade my bishop. Go, maybe I win the knight back because bishop e5. If he moves knight, okay, mine is still sinking. I don't know. I'm trying to come back. We'll see. Who would have thought I would just blunder a knight in one move? To be honest, some me, not me. Maybe somebody of you did. I definitely didn't expect just one knight. I mean, it wasn't planned this day, even wasn't planned. Yeah, I'm thinking about rook f3. I just gotta play, like, you know, fast and try to flag him. God, that's so scary. Check. Just says rook here, then I have queen. No. Rook there. Blah. Okay, that, I have this and this. No, I have that, and that's mate, isn't it? This is h2. But this mate. Oh, they're mate laborious. Well, I was all definitely keeping everything under control whole game. Definitely nothing happened. definitely. Why am I laughing? I don't know. Like, it was a perfect game which I dominated whole game. And everything was perfect. No. It wasn't. Yeah, actually b6 pawn was the reason I lost. I would keep it on b7, you would never take it. Plane speed must have fly so high. Good luck. Oh, he doesn't play dodge. No! Last time we played dodge, I beat him so nicely. Right? That was like 2 weeks ago. 3 weeks ago. Oh, so I played it 3 weeks ago. Oh, okay. Well, then it wasn't this against him. Do 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 I know b3 is like crazy move, but it looks alright. This was also 2 weeks ago? No, it was 2 weeks ago. Okay, let's close this game, let's close that game, and this game, let's skip it for analyzing it after this game is done. Yeah, I don't want to analyze during the game because, like, it's a pretty, it's a strong opening, so. So let's concentrate. I don't know, I'm saying Oh, Magnus still got an g3. Yeah, I mean, it looks like a draw. Like, probably Magnus won't be able to win. I mean, how he promotes. If Prague is pawn on g2, Magnus queen is on 8, and Magnus pawn a7, b6, win. And Magnus just gonna promote. Like, at all, basically. Like, literally at all. I was thinking about e4, but then this was, would have been a weakness. I mean, e4, yeah, right now I just wonder at this point if I play e4. So I guess I'll play like e3. Yeah, so if Magnus queen b6, pawn a7, Prague just pushes his h pawn, and then maybe Prague will be the one who is trying to win, actually. Yeah. So Magnus also has to be careful to not go too far, you know. So just in case. Let's see, I'm not sure. I'll play bishop h1. Yeah, this king g7 for me too, and then probably Magnus has to repeat. Otherwise, he has the risk. He's on the how do you say? He's on the he's risking to lose. Bam! Perfectly. Yeah. I mean, okay, right now I just want to control c file, queen c3, queen c5, and then queen c7 idea, maybe. Maybe I can trade the g2, like bishop g2, so this h3 bishop isn't annoying me. Yeah, I don't know. This, I mean, I can win a pawn. Do I want this pawn? No. So I'll play bishop g2. I mean, yeah, if I win a pawn, he has like queen b5, queen e2, get into my camp, which would be maybe a little annoying. But this queen... No better, no? And I think queen a7. Yeah, I think queen a7. And take queen b5, I have bishop a3. An idea to take on f8. And if bishop a3, then take, then I'm a pawn up. Okay. Yeah, is this bishop a3 right? I'm louder and in rook 8, no. I mean, bishop g7, I'm fine, so this. Yeah, so a7, queen e8, only move for Prague. Somewhere I think it's pretty easy to find. But after 5 hours of playing, everything can happen, to be fair. So, it's fairly simple to find while sitting here and not while playing. Maybe while playing it will be harder to find. This and then that. This queen is going to be unpleasant on g4. I mean, yeah, I think this. Yeah. Oh, this? Wait, but what if I just take, isn't it? Oh, here's queen f3. Oh, I missed that. Missed it. I think I have to do this. No, all my extra pawns, I was trying so hard to get them, I just gone now. No. Okay, let's play queen d2. Queen f2. No, not letting him to do anything dangerous to my queen, so it's going to be some time trouble fight, it looks like. c7. Eh? Okay, that's not good. It's been quite so- oh no. To make a draw and accidentally self-made it. Oh no! Yeah, okay, too, did. No! I somehow made the like only. Yeah, I mean, I had to take my was pre. Oh, no! And it took it like with 4.4. Ah! I'm playing Sakura 21. Okay, guys, I need to play like real fast. Like real fast, let's be careful so you don't have space. No! I didn't know. Ah! I messed up the lines. Ah! I thought he was just. Uh oh. Yeah, I thought he was just playing Kini 1, so if Rook A1 takes and I'm fine. Oh, that was a throw of a year! No, and I'm like understanding what just happened, and I see like his mate in one. I'm like, oh no! And when he's like zero, yes! And then he mates me, no! That was such a decent game. It's just like perfect game, and just this Rook A1 move. It's just like, okay, I was worse maybe there in the middle game a bit, but like, it was like such a perfect game, and then with like one, literally one move, I just throw it from, yeah, that was... The Rook A1, like, make any move, you probably wouldn't make me, but Rook A1, so yes, like, literally the only queen move, Queen A1. Yes, that should be such a self-made puzzle, like, you know, self-made puzzles where somebody is helping his opponent to smate him. And that was to be such a perfect one. 1 exact second. Oh, cool. That was so bad. Like, yeah, rookie two. Give another check from somewhere else. That would be a draw. And, like, he would be forced to take unless he wants to lose some time. No. But it was such a cool mate, actually. Like, look at this! Look at this! So, like, wait, real time. Rook A1, and it's like, bam, mate! And it's like, 0-0-0. I'm like, I win it! And then, no, it's mate! Oh, this game was insane. But maybe I had Queen E6. Then yes, Rook E7, I don't know. I mean, if Queen G3, Rook G2, I'm fine. But okay. Okay. E5 doesn't work for him. Pretty sure it still doesn't work because I'll take. Ah, well, now he has d4 his check. Oh no, my bishop! Well, he can't take my bishop because d is this. Be careful. Okay, yeah. But. I'm going to put this to the 2 and transform it to this endgame. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it looks like I'm in g2 and the draw will soon be agreed. Between Magnus and Prague. Yeah, Rook B7? Basically, somewhat my idea now. Just make some weighted moves. Maybe play. Let's play B4, like A5 or C5, I don't know. Ooh, that's a nice point from him. Yeah, really cool move. Okay, this. Mm hmm. They're probably going to check me like for a year and 59 months. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I'm actually like again trying to self-make myself. Oh, what? I don't know. Hopefully I'm not self- I mean, I cannot self-make myself now. Just now. No guarantee on next moves, to be fair. Wait, but... it's a draw. I just give a check and it's a draw. Wait, is it actually a draw or am I lost? Well, I'm not sure about that. It's two passers, not one. He finds his check. Oh dear. Am I again one? Do I again want to self-mate? Nah. No. Yeah, he had to go for Kineps to shoulder me. Because now this I'm winning. Well, I need to be precise though. But yeah, he had to go for Kineps 3g4. Then it would be a draw? For sure? Well, yeah, probably. Yeah, rook f4. Rook e4. This. Yeah, I know they're aqua 21. Well, that was maybe a little too close, you know? Yeah, that was like total joke. He just had to shoulder me, because after king g3, that was winning for me. Well, I wanted a quick win. I got like one of the longest games of the tournament title. Wait, I was winning here. Okay, I had to go. Oh, why didn't I play AB? Then on B7, you just can't do anything. Okay, the insane revenge. Yeah, King G6, just G2 from Prague, and then H5, King G7, he has to. Okay, so it's this, the knight, yeah, that, this. Laughing at this game, like, come on, such a nice game, better, well, was worse for two moves, but then draw, just take his pawn draw, but no, after rook A1 and something. Oh, this game will make me laugh, like, forever. Oh, yeah, that was another draw, and then, yeah, just had to play AB, and it was again draw for a while, and then I won. Hold on, this... works. I don't get mated, did I? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, Prague blind found g2, and now I mean he can move his queen. Or I mean, if queen b6 and just play king h7, and then push your pawns, or queen f3, and that's a draw. Magnus should actually think offer a draw or something. So as always, Magnus is the one who is actually worse. Okay, h6. Come on! Just self-made rook A1! I'm like, oh nice! I somehow managed to trick him and now I'm winning! Yee! Yeah, rook G2 would have been better. He wouldn't be able to take. He had to play queen D8, rook G2. He wouldn't be able. Or take my rook and stalemate. But yeah. And then I'm like, oh, rook A1, nice! I somehow, I don't know how I managed to trap him! He has 0-0-0 time! He made a move 0-0-0 and it became 0-0-0-4. Okay, let's play this. That's my idea. I'm blundering a pawn, but then F95 somehow, I think. Maybe? I'm sure. I mean, queen 6, I have queen before as well. Yeah, king E5, now queen F3. Okay, please G3. Ah, this doesn't work. I mean, it's a beautiful bishop 3 and an 85 and then pawn up. Well, it didn't work this time, but I can play queen g4 and hope that he'll fall for this trap again. Bishop c3 knight c5. And then actually, I'm winning a pawn here. Just a pawn. And I could have just played queen 7f. Perfectly nice position, but I'm playing for tricks. And now, yeah, the trick didn't work, and now I'm lost. Well, lost is a strong word. Well, yeah, I'm worse. I'm in knight g5. Yeah, queen f3, found it, and that's a draw. His queen hangs, so my idea is, I don't know what my idea is, but maybe I'll play like bishop g4, and then knight f3, bishop f3, or bishop f3 now. If he doesn't play knight d5, oh, thank you, and what I'm saying, revenge. He made a mouse there, probably. He probably want to play bishop g4. Yeah, but bishop g4 would be better, right? I mean, knight d5 lost, whatever. I was actually lost, what? I was thinking this, but then yes, yeah, it doesn't work. Minus 7, okay. I had to play for d4, I had to go for d4, and then, okay. But I didn't find it. Okay, I was, yeah. Alright, nice, let's go! Let's get more wins! Yeah, queen d8, king h7. Then Magnus will promote. Like, how much will they play for? That's interesting. And play against New Way 23. I played him today? Yeah, right. I did. That's actually a mistake. Yeah. Probably it's a mistake. Well, maybe it's a mistake for me not to take and just give him my opponent in d5 just a strong center. But I don't know. My idea is h5, h4. h4, h5, I mean. This. My idea is knight d3. How funny. b6, knight d3. Or knight knight d3 now doesn't work because of e4 and it's off work and his bishop doesn't hang. But then I can play like knight g5. Yeah, e4 is unpleasant. Ta-ra-ta-ra-ta-ra. It's really unpleasant. I'll play c3 and then knight g4. Ta-ra-ta-ra-ta-ra. Oh, wait, knight g5 doesn't work. I mean, if I don't want to be a pawn down. Well, knight for 2 pawns, so technically. 1 point of material down. Still like unpleasant to be fair. But it's funny. Let me give a check, maybe I'm not sure. Yeah, check and then like knight a6. I don't want to trade. I don't want to trade queens. Oh, knight e6, I was winning. Knight g7. Oh, maybe it's actually not that winning. He has king f7, he has compensation. And I have like bishop b5, rook c1 stuff. Ooh, what is this? No! But okay, he doesn't find it. Yee-hoo! Wait, bishop a3. Oh, am I winning by 4? Well, not by 4, so am I winning? Ah, queen c7, this. Queen d8. I'm thinking bishop c6, because I mean, if this, he has that. So let's play bishop c6. Queen c8, bishop b7, rook c8, I just take. Yeah, I mean, knight c6 was interesting. I didn't find it. Let's see. Oh, this hangs. Oh, I didn't see that. Then I play rook c1. Oh, and then he has 97. Oh, but he plays this. A castle. I did rook 7, rook c1. pawn. No, he didn't play queen b8.
Whoa, trillion queens on the board. Magnus has to go queen. That's actually a really good move. Queen c3. Somewhat nasty from Prague. I think I'll play d4. Rook c8 was... Succeed work? Yeah, it probably would. It was...
But now I was scared because, like, he has a d-passer. Wait, let's play queen d4. Let's play queen a. Okay, I'll play faster.
Oh dear. Am I again self-mating myself? I'm not sure. Yes, another new way 23. I had like 5,000 ways to win this. And of course I chose the hardest one where I wasn't even winning. Yeah, here rook c8, of course. Even there rook c8. I just was scared of this. But then I have that, and then d1 I have this. Right. Yeah. Oh, wow. My queen d4 is played, then queen d4. And queen g3 also works with this, and... Crack from Swiss check and probably it will be. Oh, I'm playing what? Berto Sen Sen Sen. Okay, I gotta play like real quick now. There's not much time left of the tournament. I think the deck was a bishop. Ooh! It's actually good. Wait. Free pop? Question mark? I'm not sure. It looks so. Looks like it, at least. Okay, bishop f6. Yeah, well, I'm not thinking, I just need to play like real quick. Bishop f6 is like safe almost everywhere. Knight d2, bishop f6. Wait, this? Isn't that another free pawn? I mean, I gave away my first free pawn. We don't know about that! But that looks like another free pawn. I'll play rook d8. And I had this bishop d6. I didn't want to risk it. I just, like, need to play quickly and safe. So I'm just safe and don't blunder anything. I mean, I'm pretty sure he has to take on c3, doesn't he? Then he takes on d8, yes. And bishop b4 is possible. Then play like c5, king c6.
Oh, and you can just give up. Anyone dream better is 777. C. Okay, that was a good game. E! Oh, my mouse. No, no! I'm clicking pause. My mouse started being goofy again. I don't know, I'll try. I mean, if okay, whatever. I'll play it. Yeah, that was a good game. But against New Way. Yeah, I just didn't see that I have this and bishop of one and win, right? Yeah, didn't see bishop one. Then I was like lost, and then I was winning, just. Okay, and then yeah, Prague is drawing. Yeah, and draw. So it looks like Abdusatorov is actually going to win the event. Interesting. It's a draw. Ah, tournament's pairing are close. Okay, okay. Thank you for the games. Congrats to Grandmaster Alex or 81, all next that, and to Fiddlemaster Glitz Hyan Gor. Will I have instant change? I'm not sure. So if performance 27-12, nice. Games played 20, nice. Win rate 75. Okay, so five games I didn't win. Then Berserker goes 0 and the average performance rating 2412. Nice. Is it Daniar? No, Daniar doesn't get a game. Is this no? Okay. It's like that. Yeah, and I'm probably 9s. Let's say we're 9s. 7s. He's playing, so if he were, probably he won't win. And yeah, and probably doesn't have, even if he draws, I mean, bishop b3. Yeah, even if he draws this, he probably will have have higher performance. Sneaky guy, actually. Okay, so 7s. Nice! Whoopsie, I forgot this. So, yeah. First, Remaster Elixir, you won 76 points. Second, Onyx Z, 57 points. Third, Fiddlemaster Glitz and Gore, 51 points. Fourth, Daniel Latipov of 2008, 51 points. Lower performance. Fifth, it must fly so high, 50 points. Sixth, Best Deeds, 45 points. Seventh, Smith, 42 points. Eighth, Fiddlemaster Carlos Ulz, 42 points. Ninth, Yusin LCKB, 42 points. Lowest performance. And then YXBAT's, 41 points. 10th. Congrats to top 10. Let me show top 100 of the tournament. I don't know why I said so weirdly, but okay. This, and that's top 100 of the tournament. Cool. So today I played 20 Blitz games, minus 15 rating, 15 wins, 2 draws, and 3 losses. Let's get to the draws. I know I'm saying so weirdly, don't ask me. So yeah, it seems like Gukesh is drawn against Aronian. And then Van Forest is still trying to win this against Geary, as it seems. Yeah, it's probably going to be a repetition if we have two. Yeah, I'm not sure though. Let's see. So the first game is Heimars M142. 2-2-1 for him, 5-1-0 for me. So yeah, F5 mistake at 0-4-knight-3. I have no idea how to play against Gambit. So I played this. I was lost. Here he had knight g5. Yeah. Just don't let me do anything, and he's just winning. I mean, yeah, he's better, but my king is like terrible. And yeah, he's actually plus 8, he's winning. And then here I go for bishop d7, knight e5, create some problems for me. And this, yeah, rook e1, he would be a pawn up. But because after bishop d3, I castled. And then, oops, this, and then knight e5 blunder, I'd go for knight d4. I found a really nice way. I mean, knight e4 would be a pawn down, but still holdable, I guess. I found a really nice way of getting the pawn back, and we traded rooks, and then I tried winning this like for a year and a half, but then he just blocks this pawns are protected, and that's the draw the name Heimars. 1-4-2. This for him it was knight g5, yep. And then it was like bishop d7, yeah, and it was knight I don't remember what it was. Knight d4? Yeah, okay. In this remaster DJ hobby, it was 1-2-0 for him, 2-1-0 for me. So yeah, d5 wasn't the best move. Here he had e5, f4, closing the position up, but he played knight d2. That, and rook d8 was a mistake for me. I had to go for knight d5, just trading. yen, and that would be equal. Then here to go for e5 here, getting more space and better position. And we got something similar as in the variation I showed you instead of rook d8, this knight d5. Just trade all the rooks, we traded the knights, then we traded the queens, and then we traded one pawn, two pawns. And then I tried to win in this. I tried my best. I tried, yeah, but he just leaves his queen on h3. Or g3 and he's fine. This and then, yeah, started actually blitzing out the moves. He also had to blitz out. And basically here, if I really wanted to win that badly, I could have done this, and just move my king around for like three moves. Like here, there, bishop c2, this like that, here. And then now, well, let's draw, isn't it? It is. But I play like b5. I know I'm lost there, but like the only idea is I play king f6, and after king f3 I know I'm lost, but I made these 50 moves and then I reply him. But I played king f6 and I decided just to offer a draw, and he accepted and drew the Grandmaster DJ hobby. So I played pretty quickly last moves and tried to flag him, but yeah, I decided just to offer a draw because flagging, yeah, it wouldn't be so nice. I mean, of course, when it's bullet flagging, it's of course it's part of the game, but as it's blitzing, it was stole for like half, more than half of the game. I decided to just off a draw, and yeah. Okay, let's see. Losses. So the loss against Semenichev Alexander, it was 6-2-4 for me and 5-3-2 for him. Hind chess 6. Yeah, I got better position from the opening, e5, got an attack. And this, I get like absolutely dominant position here. I'd go for 95, and I would be better. And I don't know, I could have just played safe this, like 98, winning two pawns, and then winning in the end game with being two pawns up. But I decided to play rook f7, this, and then I thought if he moves rook f this, and I'm like plus 5, plus 6, yeah, I'm winning. But I missed 95, and then he got some counterplay. Here, go for queen g4. I mean, I was still winning. I'd go for king h1 because here knight h3, knight f2, and it would be equal. This here, I'd go for knight h3, queen b2, and that would be equal. At knight c5, this is threat of this, and his knight hangs, so he has nothing to do. And then this, and then I would be winning, but I played rook e1. Yeah, it was slow on time, and queen e5 blunder, had to go for f4. I just hung my queen. Yeah, I just didn't see the knight was protected, and then. And basically I lost on time, but position was solved, lost in the game, 7-inch of Alexander. Yeah, I just decided to be too fancy when it was needed. Could have just played it safe and win. But I decided to be fancy and I lost. But okay, it was funny. Yeah, knight c5 was a really strong move. And it was like, I don't know, knight, no, it wasn't that, no, it wasn't this, no, it was something bad, which I don't know. Oh, I just think, yeah, okay, f4, and okay, like, rook e3, bishop a4, okay, like, I didn't know that would be a mistake, actually. I saw it was a blunder, but I didn't think it would count it here. Oh, it looks everywhere, what do you mean? Yes, oops, I didn't have the... Mm-hmm. This is Gukesh drew Aronian. Gukesh was better, he had to go for b4 instead of a5, but then that was a draw. What's the Magnus Prague evaluation? So Magnus was better, then b6 mistake, I'd go for rook b6, okay. Oh, you know what? I have like 0 f4. No, it wasn't. Maybe it was. No, it wasn't. It was a move! Probably will be some move which you will never consider. No. You know, I don't know. Well, that's really interesting. Bishop f7 is better than, for example, rook c2. Well, that's good that I actually skipped this move. Bishop f7. Can't be serious right now, can he? Lol, bishop f7. Then it's other chess 12. It was 5-5-1 for him and 5-4-4 for me. So Yeah, knight a6, mistake, I had to go for knight d7. Yeah, because of JC, my knight was just like trapped. I had to go for rook b8, I had to go for g4, yeah, and he would be better there. Knight a6, mistake, I had to go for f5, trading queens. I would be worse, but still would be quite alright. g3, mistake, he had to go for h3. He'd go for f5, he had to go for h3, he had to go for rook e5 now, he'd go for g4. Yeah, he had to do this first, because now when he did g4, I have this, knight e8, g6, and I actually got pretty good position. This, yeah, I didn't win the pawn, because otherwise my d6 would hang. This, king e4 was a mistake from him, he had to go for king f4. Is that it? No. Yeah, king f4, this, and that would be just drawn just straight, and that's okay. b6 was blunder, I'd go for king g5. And then, basically, we had got something similar like this in the game, but here, it's Zugzwang, and then if he goes this, I just do this. And then I somehow Zugzwang him out, something like this. And, no, wait, king of two moves. But king of one, make him play this, and go around, and I win him. Because after b6, I did the same sin. This, knight e4 was blunt, and I had to go for knight e2, and that's a draw. And if he goes knight e4, I just take this, and I'm winning. And here I go for knight f5. Yeah, because now my b6 pawn was a weakness, and now he has a passer, and he's winning. King f6 would be better, but this I tried. I thought, oh, that's a draw, so I'll hold in. But this, and I wasn't. And losing a mala chest 12. Yeah, basically. Oh, no! That's like 8 mistakes. It's so long. It's when you don't memorize the mistakes. Rook here, no. I was rook e4, there you go. Then king g. Yeah, b6, I just created a weakness. Otherwise, he would like never reach my pawns, and that would be more than fine position. But I just created a weakness, and I literally self-made it myself. Well, not literally, but. Well, it's not as literally as the next game will be, so stay tuned for that. I will guarantee I will make you laugh. Well, not I. The game will make you laugh. Yeah, knight e4, and then king f4, and king f6. The next game was against Inosa, flies so high. It was 1-1-3 for me and 2-0-2 for him. So, we got like completely equal position from the opening. But here I got control over c-file, and I was slightly better. I won a pawn. And here I go for g takes h, and after queen e2, I guess just take on b7. And say, I don't care. I'll play h3 and he doesn't have anything and I'm just better. But I played queen c5 and now it was equal. This, yeah, rook f3 blunder, you go for king g1 because instead of rook c2, he had f5. He would be winning d4 false and I'm lost. And yeah, here I go for f5 and with rook h8 mate ideas because now he just gave away me the f7 pawn. I was a pawner, but then he got my pawn and then he was equal. And I tried flagging him in this endgame. King d2 was a blunder, I'd go for d3. A pre-move to h6 I had to take, and I would be winning this. And here, the moment of truth. Yes, 0.9 seconds. And then, I messed the position up. I thought he would play king e1 now, and then rook a1 check. And then d1 I could play something like rook a8. But, I played rook a1. And I'm like, and then he was like back, he had time, and I realized it's mating one. And then, well, first of all, it's literally self-mated. The draw was rook a2, this rook a1, that's a draw. Or rook f2, just desperado rook, and if he takes it, that's self-mate. If he doesn't, I keep sacrificing it, and that's a draw. But I played rook a1, and his time was like 0-0-0-0, so he lost the time. I was like, yes, I somehow won. But, he played queen a1. And then he was 0-0-0-0-0-4 and he mated me. I was like, what? So I literally self-mated myself. I could have drawn so many ways, I could have win actually once if I didn't pre-move. But I mated myself. Like literally self-mated. So funny. Yeah, rook d4 and then rook e2. Yeah, just like probably like any move. Rook, yeah, I think. I mean, okay, f5. And d3. Probably. If I wanted to try to flag him, play rook g2, and if queen d8, he probably won't take my pawn in three. I mean, yes, he needs 4 moves to take my pawn. It would be like impossible with this little time. And these moves are hard, he needs to make queen move, rook move. That's hard, but I'm lost, but yeah. But yeah, to go for rook g2, that would be a draw. But it would be so hard to do with 0.9 seconds. But I self-made myself. So Jordan is still playing with Anish. Oh, that's some complications. Yeah. So finish the stream. It was very funny. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, so please join the chat. Special club teams are 1,094 members. So just 6 members on my channel, 1,100 members. So feel free to join. I'm very happy. And thank you for following on chess on YouTube and Twitch. And click the like button. And subscribe to me. And please consider please join chess. Glamis.com. And also please join my Discord. Link in the description. And yeah, bye bye. Come back. See you soon. See you more. Have fun. See you. Stay cool.